dropped Sophia off. She was so happy. The room was beautiful. It had all like sensory toys, and to be honest, I think she's gonna sleep for most of it. We took her swaddle and stuff, and there was babies like younger, like there was so many babies in there. But it was really, really cute. So I mixed up with just a Starbucks before we go swimming. I've just had this like berry crunch for my breakfast and got a bacon roll, and I got him a caramel latte. I was just going to get my waterproofing case because we want to take it on the slides. But Merry Vlogmas Day 3. Welcome to the Centre Parks vlog. It is like day 2, but our like day 1 of Centre Parks. So, yes. I hope we have a fun day. I'm so excited. I'm just mixing this up. Oh, I've just dropped seeds everywhere. But yeah, I'm excited for today. I'm missing Sophia already. You have to watch Vlogmas yesterday to know what I'm on about. She's at the crash. But yes, so excited. And let's have a really fun day. I'm so excited.
Is this the rapid though?
The rapids.
Well, what a rapid thing. You're so lightning.
I can't wait to go on them.
State, so just ignore me. My hair is still like half wet from swimming, but we went swimming. And did you enjoy yourself?
Loved it.
Sophia was so good at the crash, and I didn't realise because Dan was like, God, it books up so quickly, like for the rest of the week, but it's only on once in the week and once in the weekend. So like today would have been the only time we can took her. No, we could have taken her. But we picked her up and she was having a bottle and she was asleep. and they said she was so good, and they brought us out like an itinerary of what she did. It's so cute, I could literally cry. And so they said that she loved looking at the sensory lights, and like, yeah, she was on the mat and she liked playing with the soft toys. She was in the bouncer chair. Sorry, so cute. And then like, she slept while we had lunch, and then she woke up on her way back in, because I think it's because like, we were warm in the sports centre, then the cold hit her, like from the buggy, you know. Dan's got traffic cops on. I'm editing my vlog for yesterday's Vlogmas. And this evening, I think we're going to go swimming again, aren't we? We're going to take Sophia swimming, because we did it yesterday. We bought her some swim nappies yesterday, and I've got her a little swimming costume. So I think we're probably just going to chill till she wakes up, feed her, and then go. And then probably have a little walk, have a look at the lights. Not sure what we're going to do this evening, like tea-wise and stuff, because after we've only just had lunch. Yeah, we've had only just had lunch, to be honest with you. I had 2 portions of chicken nuggets and chips and a chocolate heaven kids mocktail. Unreal.
I've never seen someone so, not old, but I've never seen such a person that shouldn't be having it enjoy it so much.
But why shouldn't I?
Absolutely.
Because like, my perfect meal is chicken nuggets and chips, because I'm such a basic taste palette. And chocolate milk, nothing childlike about it, sorry. I just enjoyed myself. So yeah, it was really, really fun. Sorry if the TV is a bit annoying in the background. No, it's okay. But yeah, it still looks quite sunny. I want to get a little pic outside for my thumbnail, so I'm going to do that probably in a minute before it gets dark. Make sure I definitely do it before 3, because then I think the light will really start to slip. But I'll show you around this evening, take the vlog swimming. But we went on the big one, which was the tropical cyclone. No. Is that right?
Yeah.
And that one was good.
Yeah, that was
That's the one where you're in a foot and like, you go down a big dip.
So, into a big
dome.
Like, yeah.
It's a bit like the black hole at like Waterworld, yeah, where you like spin around and then drop. It's like that, but you're in, it's like loads bigger, like that's a bigger scale, isn't it? And like, you can choose the weather. So we went on that. But then we was like, there's another one. What was that called? Grand Canyon.
Something like that. Grand something.
And it was shit. It was one of the worst. Like, even like the kids' slide that you didn't have to queue was way better. Yeah. The one in the dark.
I tried going on one slide, but I wasn't allowed.
Dan was like, God, it's steep, isn't it? And he was like, yeah, well, you have to be, blah, blah, blah. And he went, oh, what, so I'm so too small? Like, it's a joke. And he was like, yeah.
It was really awkward, because he was like, yeah, you've got to be under 1.5.
Oh, and Dan went, oh, you've got to be under it. And he went, yeah. And he went, oh, I thought you were having a joke. And the man went, I was like, 6 weeks later, he did not find it funny. He didn't think it was funny at all. So yeah, we've had a fun morning. It went really, really quick. Safina was really, really good, and it was nice to be able to go on the slides. We love the rapids, because like, that's the only time really we're going to be able to go on the rapids together. But it's okay, we can just go on our own and like wait for each other at the end with Sophia, because I definitely want to go on them again.
Oh my god, shame.
Because we love the rapids so, and it really tires you out going on the rapids, doesn't it?
Yeah, it throws your body around all
over. I banged so many, like, I reckon I'm going to be covered tomorrow. Like, banged, and I got stuck with this man.
Oh my god, a man.
Well, we kept just bumping into him, didn't we? Because he was like quite slow.
A man was like the last one. So obviously the rapids are completely different to the ones at Longley.
Yeah.
But this one, the very last one, is like, it's like,
it's like this.
Just jump off it, basically.
It's really steep, isn't it?
And you get stuck under it. The current must like just keep you there.
It pulls you down, doesn't it, as well? But, like, I go right under.
Yeah, but this man got stuck under like.
No, I went first, so yeah. I was just going, and he just went straight after me.
Yeah, he came.
Got stuck under my bum. So like, I could feel him like flapping around underneath me, and I thought, I can't. Like, the current was hard, it was awful, and he was like, I got stuck. It was awful, because I like bumped into him about 3 times.
We can do it any day from 12 until like 4 o'clock, the mini golf.
Oh, can we? We want to do mini golf, badminton. We've got the pancake house for Friday.
Maybe we do the mini golf swim badminton tomorrow.
Yeah.
What do you reckon?
What, not go swimming?
We could still go swimming, but we could go swimming in like the evening. Again.
So I think it's good. I think it's nice to go in the evening with Sophia, because one, it tires her out before bed. Mm. Well, we've never been, but we think it'll tire her off. And then we can shower her so she's clean before bed too. And then like, just tea, wind her down.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So maybe. See how we get on tomorrow.
I mean, there's loads of spaces for it, so it's like, I'll just book it up tomorrow morning.
Yeah, we can. We're going to do a baby sanctuary river, but it's at 8:30 in the morning, and like, it's just a bit early.
Yeah.
Like, this morning was a rush, and like, it's not so early for us, but it's getting her right at that time, and like, her fed changed, but and happy.
And we've got it changed.
Because we don't want her to be asleep, because what's the point?
Yeah.
So I feel like it'd be better at like 1 or like 11 or like, do you know what I mean? So I don't think we're going to do that, and it's only on once a week. So yeah, that's my update so far. I'm going to carry on editing Vlogmas. I'm going to get a pic outside. We just had a green tea, Dan had a coffee. We'll feed Sophia when she wakes up. And then we'll go swimming. So I'll catch up with you when Safina is awake, but I'll also show you outside our little view.
Our view is actually really nice.
Yeah, that's why I think it'll make a cute photo.
Yeah.
I'm going to put a claw clip in and just change my top and get the cute one from the back. And we also set her mat up, I didn't show you, but she actually really liked it, didn't she?
She was kicking away on it.
This is it, and then, hang on, I'll just lift it up for you. It's got like the keyboard, I'm not going to play it because it's loud, but she really enjoyed it, didn't she? She was like really belting the keyboard, which was so cute. But I'm going to go. Going back swimming, I'm gonna put the hair in a ponytail. I'm gonna get our bag together. It is like 3:30, nearly 4:00. So we're gonna get our swimming stuff together. Sophia is still asleep. She's having a monster nap. I was gonna do some bronzing drops or something, but then I thought, I'm only going in the pool again, so what's the point? So we've got a little pale face today, which is fine. I've got our swimming costumes on the radiator and they're pretty much dry. Dan's blown Sophia's finger. So I did buy two, but I think one's going to be a bit small. I don't think she's going to fit in that, so this one it is. So I'm going to put her in this. I'm going to put her in this to go, and then I'm going to put a suit on her, and then put like a baby grips, proper stuff on her after. That's my plan. So, to walk there, I'm going to put her in a costume, a bear suit, and then I've got her winter hat somewhere. Hang on. It might be in the other bag. I don't know where it is. Oh, it's here. So I'm going to put that on her like now, change her nappy, and then for tonight's like baby grow and a vest. I'll put a fresh vest on this morning, which will be fine. So I'm just going to put on this. What baby grow should I put on her? She does like her little toes out. So I might put this on and then a suit on top. But then just, she does have a couple of little Christmassy baby grows. But it's fine. I'm not going to put this cloud one on, because she loves her hands and little toe though. So I'm just going to put this on from Asda. So I'm going to put that on for after. So let's pack Sophia's bag one sec. I'm tempted to just pack all our stuff in the dialect bag, because I feel like this is bigger than Dan's. Dialect bag. It's because dialect perfumes are in here. I meant the thingy bag. My full miraculous bag. So Dan's just making some bottles for Sophia. So we want 3 towels. This one's a little bit damp, so that's fine. So then I'm going to put Sophia's baby grow in, and the vest that she's wearing now I'll put on in there too. And then Dan's swimming trunks are here. They're a little bit damp, but they'll be fine. And then my swimming costume. Again, it's pretty much dry. This is the Kai the Label one. I actually didn't think it'd fit, but it does. It's a UK 12 and it's the Kai the Label one. And my boobs do pop out a little, but it's fine. So we've got that. And then I'll probably just wear this back out and put a coat on top because it's freezing. And then when you've been swimming, what are you going to put on? What you got on now? Back on. Do you need anything packing? What, them trousers again? We don't have any joggers?
I have, but with the white bag on.
Show me that. Just might be comfy to put on. Yeah? It's going to be dark enough. What, the wide legs? Yeah? I'm going to get Dan's. Are you going to put the tracksuit on? Yeah. He's got his cargoes. He's never even tried these on, so I hope they fit. And then I'm just going to get us some toiletries. Let's go and get them. Okay, so I'm going to empty this and put our toiletries in here. I'm going to put in my light's like hanging on. They smell so good. And then I'm going to put in my L'Occitane shower oil, my cleanser, and then we'll all wash in here. And then, yes, that's all made. And then I'm just going to put my hairbrush in because I know we're going to be a mess. Hello, darling girl.
Where are you? Where are you
tired, girlie. Are you ready to go? You can't just go. She's finally awake, and we are finally on our way. So she's got her little costume on, and she's got a swim nappy on, and they're so cute. They've got Nemo on, but she's just having her bottle, and then we are gonna go. We're all packed, and I'm excited, and we're hungry as well. So we're gonna get tea after, but I just hope she likes it. Do you think she will?
I think she will.
I can't wait to see her in her little float. Oh, sorry. It's going to be so cute. And me and Dan are going to time each other going down the rapids. See who's quicker, for me. Probably.
You're
each No, I don't. I can't help just being super fast and agile. But yeah, so I just thought I would check in. We are on our way out. It's getting dark. Oh, there's a bit of a sunset. Let me show you. I'm coming out. Yeah. Let's have a look. It looks pretty over here, look. It looks so dark. I thought there was a better sunset, but it's all going to be lit up, so I'm so excited. Do not leave your child unattended at all times.
Fifi.
Have just finished dinner. I did include a little clip of what we had for dinner. So we went swimming, and she was really good, wasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
She really. I reckon she lasted what, half an hour, 40 minutes in there.
I reckon
half
about,
an hour.
I think about half hour.
And she didn't cry once. Only when she started to get a little bit cold. Mm-hmm. I think. Do you?
Definitely.
Was the reason. And like, she didn't stop kicking like her little legs. She kick, didn't she, the whole time? She really enjoyed it. And like, I knew she would because she loves the bath. And I think, yeah, like the only reason she got, I think she was getting tired and she was cold. Like, obviously the pool is heated, but it's only so warm in there, especially when like, I don't think it's warm outside because it's in a dome. It's not really heating it. So we got changed and everything. We all had a shower there. And then we were like, what should we have for tea? So we had a look. There's a restaurant called Hooks. H-U-C-K-S. Like an American diner, like.
Yeah, I would imagine.
No, it's more of like a cowboy grill, isn't it?
Grill.
Like an American grill. And they were like, oh, it's a, at this point it was like 5:30. And they were like, we don't have to cut it away. And we were like, no, thank you. So we were like, let's have a look at Las Iguanas. So we were like, had a look at Las Iguanas. And they didn't have until...
Quarter to seven.
So we were like, just no. Like, an hour wait. So we went into the supermarket. We were like, let's just make something at home. Like, no big deal. But Sophia was like, falling asleep in the buggy. So we thought it'd be a good time to go out for dinner if we did. And then we got there, we did our shop, so we picked up some steak, we picked up some dips, a baguette, a little bit, whatever salad we could get, because honestly those shelves were quite empty, weren't they?
They were, to be fair.
And then we also picked up, we just picked up some bits, and then there was a massive queue at the till, and I was like, you know, maybe it's just because it's the evening, there's not many people working, I don't know. But the whole IT system in Literary Centre Parks that they use has gone down. So, like, we couldn't pay. So we were stood there for ages. So, like, obviously we weren't moving. Sophia woke up and she was crying. So Dan took her for a walk, and, like, I just perched on the end of somebody's till just to put the stuff down because it was getting so heavy. And how long do you reckon we were in there? Like, 20... Like, in, like, 20 minutes or so?
I think we were in there for about 15 minutes.
So 15 minutes we were waiting, and then they were like, we're just going to have to, like, to guess the prices. Or, like, they were first like, Connor's going to have to go and round and, like, add everything up for everybody's shop. I thought, the poor lad. But they didn't. So they ended up just basically, like, guessing our price. So they...
It was hilarious.
It was. So the lady came in, and she wasn't even from the park market. She was from another shop. I don't know what shop, but she was like... putting it through, and I was like, she was like, yeah. And I was like, can I have a bag? And I was like, should we call it £10? And she was like, yeah. So I got my food for like £10, and like the steaks were £5 each, and like it would have come to like 30, 40 quid.
Easy.
We got it for £10, so I felt like, great.
There was a couple of people, I was watching Mia outside, because at this point they locked all the doors up, and they weren't letting any more customers in. So Mia was literally like locked in like they would have for a bank robber.
Yeah, because they had to, like, peel the doors open for me when I come out.
The person, two people in front of me, had, like, five items. And he definitely, it would have come to, like, 30 quid. Mm. And the lady was, like, looking at it as she put it through and was like, do. And then she went to him, should we just call that 6 quid?
And he went, honest. All right.
He's like, it's almost for sure.
So
crazy.
Good. Well, they're having a full-on fight.
On
your programme. Who?
Is that Jacko, the copper?
I don't know. But there's someone in handcuffs and they're fighting.
Mm.
We're watching...
Yeah, it's Jacko.
Who are we watching?
This is Police Interceptors.
He fucking loves shit like this. We've watched it the whole holiday, 2 days, but it's always been on TV.
In another life, I would have definitely been in the gun squad.
Right, well, you're not. he always says things like this. It's quite boring.
I've got so many other lives.
What?
I've got so many other lives.
Have we all, honey? So we got back, and then I tried to feed Sophia, and she was having none of it. So she was just napping, wasn't she? I think the swimming, the day, has just knocked her out, so she's gone to sleep. We've had our tea, and now we're here, and I thought we could do a little Q&A. So I'm going to have a look on my phone and find the questions, but I just thought I'd check in and fill you in on... at evening before we commence the Q&A. So I'll find that. And then tomorrow it'll be a bit of a like more active vlog. We're gonna go and play over like badminton, mini golf. Like we're gonna do some activities. And obviously it's hard because like swimming I can only show so much. And like this evening when we went swimming, my case was just like constantly blurry, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So I couldn't get any clips, which is a shame. But hopefully if we go swimming tomorrow it'll be better. And it was fine earlier, to be fair, wasn't it?
It was. I think there was just a little bit of moisture in there.
So I might put it like by the road there and let it dry out. But I will get some questions and we'll do a little Q&A. And then me and Dan are going to have our crisps. I'm so excited. We thought we would do a Q&A. you're my hair.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. I have loads of questions. I feel like Dan will be low-key looking right as well, so...
Looking right.
Oh, it's just gone off, you pig. You pig. Yeah, look, looking at Cops Wars, whatever it's called. What were your change in symptoms through the different trimesters?
Mine.
Mine. Can you remember? So first, I was absolutely knackered
all the time.
Felt a little bit sick.
Yeah.
But just exhausted, I'd say the main was.
Exhausted.
So I'd say exhausted. Second one, honestly, nothing crazy.
No,
I was quite happy the second trimester.
I was going to say, you, I think you had kind of by that point embraced the the bod.
I loved second trimester, yeah, really. Like, I was getting tired towards the end.
Yeah.
But, like, overall, I was okay. And then third trimester, obviously, like, if I go back and watch my vlogs, I probably did have other symptoms, but, like, thinking back, my third one was heartburn was the worst.
Oh, it was horrendous.
Heartburn and also restless legs.
Yeah. Constantly, like, oh, I need my...
Me Rennies. Like, we were buying packs and packs, weren't we?
Literally every day.
Every day. And just, I feel like towards the end, you're just uncomfortable and exhausted.
Mm.
I'd probably say, would you?
I'd say so.
Trying to conceive journey, to be honest, we were really lucky. Obviously, we did have a miscarriage in 2021.
Mm.
Or 2020?
2020.
2020, so. And we were like, you know, and then we started trying for a baby in October, like mid to end October, and we fell pregnant the first week of December, so we were really lucky. Fertile kings and queens. Mm. Someone said, do you have any advice for someone who wants to start trying for a baby? I'd say just try not to put much pressure on it. It's really hard, but I think, like, you'll know when you're both kind of ready. And, well, you think you're ready.
Yeah.
We'll get onto that, but I feel like you think you're ready, and then you know, it can take people, the average is 6 months to a year, I think. So, yeah, I would say, just don't try not to put pressure on it.
Yeah.
Do you? Yeah, it's hard, but, like, you just have to think, like, it will happen when it happens. And, like, you're meant to have the baby when you're meant to have the baby.
Yeah.
Someone said, did you use everything in your hospital bag?
No,
nothing.
Far from it.
I used in my hospital bag. I did try the TENS machine, but I was in so much pain. I'd been in labour so long at that point. Wasn't interested. Didn't have what help, did it?
It was pointless having it.
Didn't use the cooling spray.
Pointless having it.
Didn't use the... What I did use, I'd say I used the... I didn't use the Perry bottle. I used the wipes. The cracking cooling pads. The nappies, my pyjamas.
Spare clothes, yeah.
No, well, I just stayed in pyjamas the whole time. Bras.
I feel like you can really...
But it depends on your birth. Like, if you are fully, like, competent and you're, like, not overtaken by the pain and you're like, God, I'm a bit bored.
Yeah.
If anything, you'd probably have stuff to do and, like, you might want... Oh, I would have liked my fan, but my fan ran out.
It did, really quickly.
I'd have really liked my fan, is one thing I would recommend taking, because you get fucking hot and bothered when you're in pain.
Yeah, you were very just bothered, weren't you?
But to be honest with you, like,
it's just completely fair enough.
I was just in Delulu Land half the time, wasn't I?
It was wild.
Really? Someone says, what are your opinions on driving an hour and a half with my new baby to see my family?
Right. Do not ever listen to things like this. Just my opinion, and I'm speaking from a dad's point of view, so a mother's point of view is going to be completely different. But from a dad's point of view, all I would say is for years and years, people would drive up and down the country without any issues. It's only recently that people have started putting little recommendations on things, getting in your heads.
The guidelines.
It's absolute bollocks. The amount of, like, this is a bit off topic, but the amount of information Mia's told me about how we should warm bottles up, how we should store bottles up. And do you know what we're doing? We're just doing what we think's best.
Yeah, I think you've got to do what you think. And I'd say, like, regardless, like, we drove with Sophia when a 3-hour journey when she was
two weeks old.
But we stopped about an hour and 20 in.
Yeah.
I was obviously checking on her on the way she was moving and stuff. But I think as long as the baby's head isn't like this, like completely blocking the airway, because that's what it supposedly is, like the pressure of the baby's head, because it's heavier, blocking the airway, which, you know, they do their research, I understand.
Yeah.
But I think as long as you're keeping your eye on your baby, every 20 minutes is ridiculous.
I just think people just need to be a bit more realistic with it. Because, like you've just said, the recommendation, is it half an hour you meant to see it?
20 minutes. I think it is, yeah.
I thought it was half hour. But
I think it's 20 but minutes. I don't know. Either way, there's not much in it.
You are not going to stop. Realistically, if your baby is asleep when you're driving, that's perfect. That's where you want them to be asleep.
Yeah, it is. And like the car puts them to sleep. The longest we've probably gone without stopping for is like an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Would you say?
And I don't think that's unrealistic.
No, and we check on her. And like, I feel like that's all.
Because realistically, you want to stretch your legs after a good hour.
I understand. Yeah, exactly. And as long as
and we've got
not...
the dog as well.
Yeah.
So it's not like we're ever
going
to push it too much.
Do what you think's best.
Yeah. So an hour and a half, I would say, probably, if you feel comfortable, do it the whole way.
And like, sit in the back with, like, if someone else is driving, if you like feel anxious about the full hour and a half, sit in the back with them.
Or
like,
if not, just stop after 45 minutes.
Yeah, do half the
just
journey.
Just do half the journey. Get some petrol. Get a little snack.
Yeah.
Like, don't put pressure on it. Don't stress yourself.
Someone said, "How are you coping being a mum and dad mentally?" I'd say it changes all the time, and it depends on the day.
Yeah, there was a point in time where I genuinely thought, "What the fuck have I done?"
Me too. At the start, we hated it.
It was like the first week was okay.
Yeah.
But then, about a month in, I think we both... It was one Friday night, and I've said this to a couple of people, like a couple of my customers that I've spoke to about it, because they were all interested in how we're getting on. And I've said the same thing to them about it. But it was this one Friday night in particular. I got home from work at about 5, and we were sat on the sofa, weren't we? And we just started crying towards each other. And... it was like, we needed it.
We felt depressed.
We were so down.
And I also think it was hard because Sophia was so unsettled and we didn't
know
at the time with her milk.
Yeah.
So it's not her fault, like she's not a bad baby. Like
she's such a happy baby, really.
She is. And like we just obviously didn't know because we were first time parents. And like you do feel like you're drowning a bit. Like you just feel like you've lost yourself completely. All your freedom, all your routine, like... all time for each other.
Mm.
Like, it is a wild time, and I feel like people don't talk about it enough. Like, they just talk about this newborn bubble. But, like, the newborn bubble was quite depressing. Like, now I look back, I think, God, she was so small, she was so perfect.
Yeah.
But, like, actually going back to them times, they are quite dark times.
It was, it was a really strange period. And because we've obviously never had to before, but putting someone else's needs... and like just them in general in front
and
of your
also
own.
Only children, which I don't think helps. Like if you've had like a little brother, you've seen like the crying, the sleepless nights with your mum, maybe like you're not as like shocked.
I didn't realise how selfish I was as a person until I had a baby.
Mhm, 100%.
Because it isn't just being able to go out and go to the gym when you want, or you know, all these little things like go to the shop without. Having to, one of us either stay at home with her or we all go, and then she gets upset because she doesn't want to go in a car seat. Like, there's so many different things now.
Yeah, but like now we're used to it.
Yeah,
like, so like, she's probably going to cry if we burp her now. Like, she's probably going to cry when we put her in the car seat. Like, she might cry when we put her in the buggy when we
help her. You just anticipate it, don't you?
Yeah, but I'd say like every day is so different. Like, don't get me wrong, we love our daughter so much. But some days we do find it hard on that side.
Some days I think she is an absolute twat.
Me too.
But that is okay to say that.
It is, it's fine because
I think most people are twats every day.
Yeah, literally.
And so
like and she
is what it is.
Yeah, it is difficult, but it's also like beautiful at the same time. Like you've made a human and you're like watching them grow and learn, like they're seeing the world for the first time, like it's crazy.
Yeah.
Like that baby's never been swimming before.
I've never ever felt such a level of like protection over something.
Mm. Yeah,
it really is.
You
like,
just want her to, but you don't want to put her in bubble wrap. That's the wrong word, but like you just want
to
like.
No, I never want to do that.
You
her,
just
want
to like. You don't want her ever to get harmed.
Yeah.
Hurt, like.
Just,
sad.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
You just want them to be happy and like feel like all the good feelings.
There's nothing better than when she does her little smile.
Because like, no matter what kind of day you're having. When she smiles, you can't help smile back. Even if she's been a pain, that won't sleep.
God.
She smiles for a dummy, and you think.
Yeah. You walk up and you try to put the dummy back in, but she's smiling at you.
It's so hard.
It kills me.
It is. Someone said, have you noticed any changes with Rory since Rolo passed? I know dogs really feel it.
Oh my God, so many.
We have. I'd say, like, he's so different with food. His own food doesn't really like it as much. Our food, obsessed with it.
Crazy for it. And we're not those sorts of people to give him lots of snacks. We'll give him any of our food. We give him the odd little bit here and there, but never like, you know, some people absolutely cane it, don't they?
Yeah. I'd feel like he has changed quite a bit, and he's like very like protective over me. He's very attached to me now.
Yeah.
And someone said, like, how are you coping with the baby and Rory? Rory's golden.
Yeah, he absolutely adores Sophia.
He is the perfect dog.
We literally have to pull him away
from licking. Because he's kissing her face off. Because I'm like, you know, it's probably not the best going in her mouth when he eats raw meat. But, like, he adores her. Like, he kisses her. He sits by her. Like, he never gets upset. Like, the first week or so, he did worry. As in, he was upset when she was upset. When she was really crying, he'd cry. And, like... He's such a gentleman with her, isn't he?
He's very gentle. The only thing we have to be careful about is where he's been so used to just jumping up onto the bed or the sofa. If
he doesn't know she's like under it, like say she's on the floor or if she's like on the sofa, he just jumps up and we're like, careful!
Yeah, so that's the only thing.
And sometimes he puts his paw on her tummy and we're like, get your paw off, sir.
But the amount of times we've been changing her nappy or something like that, he'll jump up next to her and just lie down and plonk his head on.
It's so cute.
He absolutely adores her.
He does, doesn't he? Yeah, he does adore her. And someone said, what was Sophia's almost name? Were we set on her name the whole time? We didn't have a name for quite a while. Good few months into it. I'd say we've got a list of names, like names that we almost called her.
Annabelle?
Loved Annabelle, but you didn't like it as much.
No, I didn't like it as much. I liked Arabella.
We both really still like Arabella. Like, if we had another girl, that could vote. Unless we find another one, that's probably second.
Yeah, I did like Arabella.
I can't think what else.
Aria was a long time one, wasn't it?
Yeah, but now it's, like, I can't imagine calling Sophia Aria now.
No.
Can you?
No.
I really can't. It's crazy. Someone says, how are you feeling in yourself postpartum? I don't know. What would you say?
What was a question for you?
Yeah, but how would you say I'm feeling?
I think you're a lot better. I think you're a lot happier.
I'd say the first few weeks, or 2 weeks, is really quite
low. You were an emotional wreck postpartum initially.
First 2 weeks.
Yeah, like...
I was so sad.
Every day you
Not cry. Every day, like, I wasn't sad the whole day.
No,
but I'd have things where, like, waves, like, just emotion would just fly over me and I'd cry.
It was a wave sort of thing.
But I'm... She's awake. My ear hearing is, like, it's gone, like, supersonic with her, like, seeing... I feel like I can hear her breathe from another room sometimes. I feel like I'm okay. I feel like... Every day is different. I feel I'm not crying as much. Like, I'd say I cried quite a lot in the first few weeks, but I still feel emotional some days, and that's fine. Like, I'd say I feel more emotional now over things, but, like, overall I'm fine. Like, I feel like myself, whatever that is. Like, I feel like, okay, I'm good. I'd say, like, I'm fine overall. Like, I'm not, like, sad every day. Like, I think I definitely had a bit of baby blues, but I wouldn't say I had, like, anything other than that, like, the sadness has definitely gone. Sadness has definitely got less and less. But I also think, like, I found it really hard losing Rolo at the same time. Like, I think it's been really, really hard. To be honest with you. I really do. Someone said how to make pre-made bottles. I don't know how to do it. Okay, so what we do is we boil the kettle and then we leave it for 20 minutes, but try not to leave it any longer than 30 minutes because it's around 70 degrees then. Like, that's like the perfect temperature to kill the bacteria, but, like, I don't know the full science behind it, but I just follow it to the optimal bottle at the start. So we make a pre-made bottle. We probably do, like, enough or just under for the 24 hours.
Yeah.
So, and we usually do one big bottle for the evening. So, boil the kettle, leave 20 minutes, sterilise bottles. We fill all the waters to like the minute that her average bottle is
five. Wrong.
What?
What you're doing is so bad for her.
Shut up. 5 ounces, and then 5 scoops of formula, swirl, fridge, long as they're all done in 24 hours. And then when she needs them, chuck them in a mug, boiling water, warm it up, feed. People have their own opinions on that. That's how we do it. She's fine. It's how my mum did it, my nan did it, whoever else. That's the best way to do it. Feeding on demand, I think, is mental. But we'll leave that there. Unless you're breastfeeding, obvs. Someone said, me and my other half would love a baby, but I'm really nervous because it's a big change. Any advice? I think don't go into it thinking your life's going to be the same. Don't go into it thinking like, no, the baby will just slot into our life. Wow. Because like, like you do become like, you do become like, well, can't go out, she's asleep. You're a slave.
You are a slave to her. And there's never, there is never a right time to have a kid. So if you're kind of thinking about doing that, you're probably ready for it.
Someone said, was giving birth anything like you thought it would be?
No. It was so strange.
It's a mental experience, isn't it?
Yeah. And I don't know whether ours... Well, every pregnancy story is completely different. So there's no point ever trying to compare yours to others. But ours was mental because we were losing our dog.
Yeah.
So we're turning up to the hospital with our dog in a hospital on a drip, and we can't get a parking space in the hospital car park. Mia's waters are broke and they're like flying all over the floor. We can't get a space because the builders have taken up all the spaces.
She's crying.
This is the moment where I think she's a twat, you see, because I've got to get up now. I love her, but I think she's a twat.
Someone said, birth is wild. Wild. Like, everyone's experience is so different, so don't go into it. Like, just don't have a birth plan. Like, have an idea of what you want, and if you get it, slay, but do not think, like, I am not going to be happy if I don't get this, because potentially you may not get what you want. Do you have any advice how you would get through pregnancy? Just take every day as it comes and just think, my body's doing an amazing thing, be grateful for it, take rest when you can, and enjoy the peace and fucking quiet if it's your first.
Enjoy the peace and fucking quiet.
Enjoy sitting down and having dinner. Enjoy getting up when the fuck you want. Yeah. Enjoy going to bed when you want.
When
enjoy.
There's peace and quiet, there is nothing better. How many times have we said to each other, oh, that's nice. That's nice.
This is nice. That isn't when it cries. Someone said, did you do any antenatal classes or reading to hypnobirthing? We did nothing.
Nothing.
Not a thing.
You tried a bit of hypnobirthing.
Yeah, and like, yeah, I did hypnobirthing, but like antenatal classes, it does just come. Might take you a few days, it comes, but as long as that baby is fed, changed and clean and loved, you cannot do anything else for it. It doesn't need anything. And like they tell you, and what my biggest advice would be is ask while you're in the hospital. They tell you how to change a nappy. They were amazing. They tell you how to feed the baby. They give you advice. They help you with latch. They're amazing. They're absolutely amazing. Best baby purchase you've used so far? We had this question the other day.
We've spoken about this quite a few times recently.
Love the Cybex car seat, fucking beautiful.
The spin,
the base, that's the base, so you can get other car seats for that. The Isofix 360, Max Cozy 360, whatever it is, Cybex car seat, the Nigel carrier.
Yeah, banger that is.
Dummies,
yeah.
Tommy Tippy anticolic bottles.
People have their opinion on dummies.
They do.
So do we.
We like Tommy Tippy and Mam dummies, do we?
Yeah.
No prep. She does use the Mam ones a little bit more.
She does. I think the tits are a little bit smaller.
But then we prefer the Tommy Tippy bottles.
Yeah.
The anti-colic ones are our favourite.
The Tommy Tippy steriliser.
The UV steriliser is so good.
Brilliant. We've literally brought it to Centre Parks with us. We took it to the lake.
We don't go anywhere without it.
It makes life
The man
so
bottle
much
wash
easier.
Is nice. The Milton bottle cleaner, yeah. I'd say. I like our next to me crib because you can adjust. So, like, we always have her on a slight incline, and if she's like chesty or anything, we put it on a bigger incline, but she's always on an incline because that helps her digestion and stuff, and she just sleeps better.
She does, to be
a little bit inclined. We feed her upright, so I'd say we've got the.
And it's so easy to get up and get down.
And it goes flat in a bag.
I do it, I can take it down in about 3 minutes and put it up in about two. It is so easy.
It is, it's so good. It's the Tutti Bambini cosy in Scandinavian walnut and ecru, I think.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
It is brilliant, and it's just really, really good.
It's more a question of, for us, like, things we thought we would use.
But we don't.
But we don't touch. Like, for one, the Moses basket.
Don't use the Moses basket.
It's being used as a storage.
Because she won't sleep in the day, really.
Unless it's in our bedroom.
That's what I mean. Like, she's not in the day. I mean, she won't sleep in the light. She needs nighttime stuff.
Yeah.
Swaddles.
Swaddles.
Love swaddles.
Brilliant.
Don't love every swaddle, but the Love to Dream. So good.
What was that one that we tried? The Velcro.
Kite Baby.
Fucking hell.
And, like, yes, it keeps the baby in, but when you unlock it in the night to change them, it startles them because it's like...
Honestly, silly. Earthquakes are quieter.
Silly. When people say being a mummy's hard, why is that? Just wait and see.
When you have a kid, you'll know, mate.
Yeah, and it's not to scare you, but, like, everyone has their own battles with motherhood and fatherhood.
Coming from a father, I was absolutely petrified of her to start with.
Yeah. Petrified. Yeah, someone said, did you bond with your baby straight away?
No.
Not at all.
Didn't like her.
Terrified of her.
Did not like her.
It's the shock. And, like, after such a traumatic time, you almost think, like, you kind of put that onto them. Like, you've put me through a load of pain. Yeah. Like, I don't really... Not I don't, like you, but I'm not... Fuck, it's so overwhelming.
I resented her from a point of I didn't feel, one, as close to Mia as we used to be, and two, my life had changed because I could no longer live my life the way I'd lived it before. So I feel like, again, that Friday night, it's funny because a couple of the customers that I spoke to about it have all said exactly the same thing happened to them. It was like you had this realisation where you're like... Fucking hell, like, we either embrace it now, and, like, this is our new life, or you keep fighting and fighting and fighting to the point where you just get depressed from it. So, yeah, that's where I'm at with it.
Yeah. But, like, the bond grows more and more and more 100%. Every day. Like, you love that baby more. Yeah. Like, don't worry if you don't have a bond straight away. Like, you're still loving... As long as you're loving and caring for that baby's needs, it doesn't matter.
And you also, because...
You're kind of faking it till you make it.
Because you're essentially doing everything for the first time again. Like, today, we went swimming with Sophia...
For the first time.
For the first time. And she absolutely loved it.
Yeah.
Like, it felt exciting. We've both been excited to do that because we knew how much she'd enjoy it.
Yeah.
And I guess, like, other experiences will be in the future, like going on, like...
Holiday.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, everything, every first she does is fun.
It's going to be fun.
And, like, but then, like, I don't know, it's just exciting when they're that little bit more alert, they do a little bit more, because, like, at the start they are just a bit like potatoes, and, like, she is a potato, really. She can only
she can,
kick
like, yeah, and she can kind
start
of...
trying to sit up a little bit.
She shuffles herself up and down, doesn't she?
I feel like it's getting to the point now where I'm, like, a bit more hesitant of leaving her on, like, if I put her in the corner.
Don't say that.
No, well, it's true. So, like, say if I put her on the sofa, like, in the corner, which I do, I feel like now I have to block her in. Like, I'm a bit, like, more hesitant, because I'm like, is she moving? Whereas, like, before, I'd be like, she's not going anywhere.
She couldn't.
No. I also really like the, we did really love, when she's younger, the sleepy heads. There's a lot of controversial advice about them.
Yeah,
but supervised, no problem. Supervised, I think they're really good because, like, they've got somewhere to sit on the sofa, like, not sit.
She loves our sleepy head. She genuinely looks so comfy in
She does. And again, like, as long as you're not leaving them in it on their own, like, their faces aren't getting smushed against it, like, I feel like it's fine.
Just
use your common sense.
Common sense.
Someone said, when are you guys moving? Are you moving far from where you currently are? Not really.
We're moving, like, 10-15 minute drive away.
10-15 minute drive away, and we assume March will be at completion.
Probably March. Back end of Feb, March.
Someone said, did you decide not to breastfeed? I found it hard, didn't I?
Do you know what? You found the latching okay.
It was
painful
the supply,
to start,
wasn't it?
But you got the latch to a T, really. Which was great.
Your
supply just wasn't there, was it?
But then it also, like, I wasn't seeming to be satisfied. Like, she always seemed to be hungry.
Mm.
But then, like, when I think about it as well, obviously I was always had lactose in my diet. So, like, obviously we were unaware of it. But next time, I will give it another go and I'll try.
That's all
you can do.
Because, again, every pregnancy is completely different.
And I remember watching Gemma Miles. She couldn't breastfeed with Noah, whereas Jonah, I think that's his name. He breastfed immediately.
I guess because your body has now gone through pregnancy once, there's so many different hormones that have been created in your body.
Yeah.
To prepare you for the second one, if there is a second one.
Yeah. Yeah, someone said, how did you find New Cross? Loved it. It was really good. All the midwives were lovely.
They were unreal, all of them.
They were really lovely.
They were all, like, just so helpful. Like,
they were really kind,
yeah,
a lot of them.
Yeah,
we didn't meet one nasty person. Apart from one midwife, is a bit harsh, but apart from that.
But that was because it was at like 3 o'clock in the morning and we were tired.
Yeah.
We got woken up but I had to change them.
I know, which is wild.
But she's obviously getting you ready for the realities of, like, if you need to change a nappy at 3 o'clock in the morning, you're changing that nappy at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Absolutely.
They were all class.
Someone said, how do you make your bottles for Sophia when you're out and about? So two ways. We overtake...
it's disgusting how you do it. Wrong.
We overtake the bottle out the fridge and I put it in a bottle bag, which I'd need to just double check, but I think it keeps it warm or cold, whichever temperature it is, for 2 hours. And then for the guidance around it is once the bottle reaches room temp, 2 hours post that. So I would say... we either do the rapid call, so we do a flask of hot water, but invest in a good flask. But we use the Tommy Tippy one, so flask of hot water, formula pot, and then the rapid call, 1 ounce, put your formula in, shake, the rest in the rapid call, do the rapid call, pour the rest in, shake, feed.
These two are good questions.
Go on.
How are you finding the night feeds? That's one thing
we're not doing them at the moment.
We don't do them right now. Because this little gem right here has absolutely researched the shit out of it.
At the moment,
basically just feed him up as much as you can during
the day. So what I want you to, if any of you have got a newborn who is struggling, okay, this is a jug of the baby's, like, hunger. All day, feed, do not worry about everything.
But your baby might be completely different,
yes,
so this might
not work.
Yes,
this is just my advice and not what I've researched.
Yeah.
Feed, because at the night it's going to take it longer to get to zero, screaming hungry in sleep.
So the measurements for us with our milk, the recommended guidance is 4 times a day feed, 4 ounces to, like, four scoops to 4 ounces of water. We put in...
5 ounces
to 5 scoops.
About 4 times a day.
4 times a day.
And then we do one 8-ounce bottle.
But she won't...
She's never done eight ounces.
And it's rare that we get a full house of 5 ounces.
And she doesn't have 5 ounces every day consistently.
That's
sometimes
what I'm saying.
She needs two.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So someone will say that we're doing it completely wrong. But our midwife has come round and said she's putting on weight well.
She's
healthy.
She's doing fine. If anything, that little baby. She's got chunky little thighs and stuff.
She's filling out
lovely.
So, again, it might be different for your baby, but Sophia can now go a whole night.
And she doesn't.
Without waking up.
My advice, and, like, we feed her every 3 to 4 hours,
yeah,
depending on when she wants sleep.
But sometimes she'll miss a gap where
and
she doesn't.
Sometimes she'll
go
like 6-7 hours, and, like, but that's just her choice. That that baby won't feed if she doesn't want it. She'll never just feed for the sake of it. She'll spit the bottle out. But my advice is try and feed as much as you can throughout the day, because then it takes them longer. Like, they only wake up really unless something startles them for food.
Another thing that we've learned as well, buy the better nappies.
Pampers are a really good nappy brand, because I did change it to economic ones, and we tried the Aldi ones, tried the Tesco ones.
The Aldi ones leaked a lot.
Yeah.
We kept waiting.
In our opinion.
Yeah, in the night.
Because we sized up and kept, like, we tried two different sizes and they leaked in both, didn't they?
We'd have to wake up in the night to change.
Whereas now she can go like the full night sleep, 12 hours or so, without a nappy change, and she's fine.
It's a game changer.
It takes a long time for it to leak. The temperature's getting a little bit hot. But giving birth to the placenta, someone said, I had to have an injection, it wouldn't come out, so I don't know what it was like. But giving birth is the funniest thing. You're like, whole body's like, blah, blah, blah. It's wild.
You said that.
So weird.
But also as well, TMI for anyone who's a bit mad about gore and stuff, so go away now. The midwife dropped our placenta on the floor.
The whole bath. It was like a murder scene. It was horrendous,
so
wasn't
they
it?
They had to get the healthcare. There were like three healthcare mopping up the floor.
Yeah, literally.
And then they had to move Mira out of the bed because they had to, like, basically mop everywhere.
Literally. Someone said, why didn't you have a baby shower? I didn't want one. You don't feel pressured to follow the traditional have a baby shower. You can do what you want. It's your pregnancy and your thingy. Someone said, how did you overcome the fear of pregnant after a miscarriage? I'd say, just trust the process. Try and think, if I'm meant to have this baby, I will. And secondly, private scans. Paying for private scans is my answer. I just paid for them for reassurance whenever I could. Luckily, I was in a position to afford it. They are a bit more expensive, but they do give you reassurance, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
Someone said, is your partner allowed to stay the whole night? Not traditionally, but I asked and they found a bed for us.
We were lucky.
Someone said, is it hard for you to do your whole life on social media? Do you feel like you need a break? Sometimes, yes, but I do really enjoy it.
You've had a couple of little wobbles, haven't you?
Yeah, but sometimes I do enjoy it, but sometimes I do find it a bit overwhelming because I feel like, I don't know, I feel like I have a lot to do all the time.
Yeah. It's hard. It's like, especially with me being like out at work all day.
Yeah.
Like for you, I guess it's hard to, one, not feel guilty that you're not doing your own work because you're trying to like be present with Sophia. And then two, like the house work dwindles.
It's hard to balance.
It's so difficult. And then, but then, like, we've kind of worked out that, you know, I can do things. You don't realise how like valuable spare time is when you have a baby.
No, that, like, even an hour, there's so much you can do in an hour.
So much.
Like, we can clean the house so fucking quick.
That's two washes done.
It's a hoover, it's a wipe, it's a...
Yeah.
Someone said, quickly, because I think we might die, has birth put you off having another baby?
Me personally, no.
Sure.
Twat again.
I'd say I'm coming round to the idea more, but I still don't feel ready to go for it again because it was a traumatic birth and I do feel a little traumatised. But to experience this again, yes, because although I find it hard, I love this baby so much and she's my whole world, and like I can't imagine never experiencing having this little baby again, if I'm honest. And someone said, did you use a compression belly band after birth? No. Someone said, does Sophia have a middle name? No. Do I think I was naive going into birth? Yes. Absolutely. I do.
It wasn't intentionally though.
What?
Like, you just thought, you were
well, I didn't
like,
know what to expect, obviously, but I was like,
yeah,
I'll smash it.
Walking in there like
Conor
McGregor, like, flat your shoulders about.
I thought I would have smashed it a bit more, but I didn't, and that's fine. Well, I didn't not smash it, but it just was what it was.
You did smash it.
I did the best I could with the situation I was given. And would you recommend the eye candy? I would recommend it. It's just a heavy-duty pram compared to the Nuna.
Mm.
I'd say they're both completely different, but, like, I'd say the eye candy is probably better quality and a lot more heavy duty. The Nuna is a lot more lightweight, easy to fold. But I prefer, I'd probably say the eye candy is better looking.
Yeah.
And I'd say it looks more bougie and it is more expensive. But like when she's older, I would definitely use that, I think. But like the Nuna folds up so small. Like if you have a small car,
it's like an ironing board.
Like this, and like the adapters are a lot easier than the eye candy. It's less faff.
It's very, very like single parent friendly.
Oh my god, yeah. Like, it's so easy to flap. That and the Cybex are a dream team. But
the Cybex is
amazing. Yeah,
it's great. But she is, like, we think she's so much happier in her Cybex car seat than the Nuna.
Massive.
Whether it's the way the body's sat in the Nuna compared to the iCandy, but the Cybex is, she's definitely happier. And you can recline it, so.
And also, I was just about to say, the reclining is a fucking godsend, isn't it?
Definitely.
It's amazing. But I think we'll leave it there. We've chatted for 37 minutes.
Have we?
Yeah, it's gone 40 minutes, so that'll add a nice little size to the Vlogmas. But I will vlog any more this evening if there is anything to vlog. But if not, I'll speak to you tomorrow. But if so, enjoy the rest of the vlog. Love you. Hope you enjoyed. Say bye and see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Goodbye.
My secret to gifting? Personalised jewellery that shows them just how well you know them at Abbott Lyon.